useless ukulele tips. Maybe you can use 1, 2, 3, 4. Absolut sinnlose ukulelen tips sind manchmal gar nicht so schlecht. In Hamburg, Hi, this is PD Forrest, and this is my 11th useless ukulele tip. And it's going to be the last one. And if it's going to be the last one of the series, we're going to go out on a bang. And how are we going to do that? Well, we're going to bring you to Hamburg, Germany. And I went there just in September. And what's special in Hamburg, Germany? There's a Beatles ukulele tour. And why is this tip useless? It's only useless if you can't afford a plane ticket or to get to Hamburg, Germany. Then you can't do the tour. And this is a shout out, but otherwise it's very useful. So this is a shout out for Stephanie Hempel's Beatles-Tour. It's a ukulele Beatles-Tour, and you visit the clubs that Beatles played before they became famous. It was fantastic. I've been waiting for years to go there. So this is a shout out to Stephanie's tour, and Stephanie. And here's me with Stephanie on the tour there, just to show you that I actually went, and kind of a retro shot. And behind me also is the skull and crossbones, and the area where the Beatles played in 1960-61 before they became famous in Hamburg is called St. Paul's area, where there's cool clubs, and it's off an area, it's called the Reeperbahn, and it was a bit rough in the 60s, and here's a picture of the Reeperbahn now during the day. You see these outdoor tables. And where the Beatles first played, it was a place called Indra Club on a street called Die Große Freiheit. And they played there for a little bit. And then they played the Kaiser Keller. And that's where they met these German friends. And these iconic pictures of them in black and white are taken by a photographer named Astrid. And a guy named Klaus first found them, the Beatles, just walking by. And eventually they played at the Star Club and the Top Ten. And the Star Club burned down. I don't need to show you all the tour because you'll go on the tour, but these are just a few shots to see about that. And there's also, what's interesting, is the John Lennon doorway, which you visit too, and you can get pictures taken in front like here my friends did. And I attended with some friends from Bremen and a friend from Hamburg, and my Bremen friends took lots of great pictures along the trip. But here's the funny thing. About 3 or 4 days after returning to Canada, I got an email from someone who said they were on the trip. And he sent me a picture in front of myself in the John Lennon doorway. Here it is right now. Fantastic picture. Fantastic. And he said to me that he went on the trip, about 2 weeks later, he bought his first ukulele. So he went to YouTube and looked for videos, beginner's videos, and suddenly he saw me on there. So he went, wow. So he contacted me and sent me that great picture. And that, his name is Mount, and I really thank him for that. That really made a great souvenir of the trip and a great story. So this useless tip is very useful for my good memories. And also, you can play with Stephanie while she plays Beatles songs along the way. So you feel free to bring your ukulele along. I did, but I didn't play it this time. I was trying to photograph things and take some videos. Now, my friends, Katharina and Andreas, here's a picture of me and Andreas before this cool Beatles poster that is there at the Kaiser Keller. And anyways, in front of where the Star Club used to be, Stephanie closes out with Twist and Shout and invited my friends Katrina and Andreas to play. And they're from Bremen and they played here. And that guy Belt sent me this great video. So thanks to everyone, it was an amazing trip. And enjoy the final video and Auf Wiedersehen. Tschüss.
Rock and roll. Yeah, we have two ukulele players. Come here. They brought the ukulele.
Oh, wow.
Give them a hand.
Yep.
Okay. Yeah. So, ukulele tour. Twist and shout. Ich sing vor, ihr singt nach. Come on.